The 23 gauge needle as an opening. Look around and go around the vessels and then stretch the tissue side to side, not in and out. That will create a bruise. So we stretch, make it wide enough opening, then we insert the cannula. This is important because when you put it in, you can inject a little bit of product that creates a potential space, makes it very easy to advance it. And you can put anywhere from 1 to 3 mLs below the eye, depending how aggressive you want to be and how much downtime. 1.5 mLs of PRF is typically what we use. You do not need a lot of product. So we'll cleanse the area, a little poke here. It feels a little bit different. Down. We're on the layer of the periosteum here. So you can see with the Plasmasculpt, you can already see that fibrin clot forming and the Sculptra and the PRF mixed together, but that fibrin clot forming already in our syringe, that's in the body and in the areas we're filling, that's what's creating a slow release of the growth factors and the PLLA in specific concentrations. And we're injecting, we can inject with this product along the actual folds because we want a little bit of volume here. Now when we come lower, we already see a little bit of creping skin here, a little poke. You're doing amazing. And that crepiness, you can see that clot here, we're gonna have to get a new one because we have a little clot here. So we'll get a new needle there. We did the lower face, we did the other high cheek. We're gonna do the periosteal Plasmasculpt, little poke here. And we're always playing off the zygomatic bone. It's a safe level, but also working off the bone to create youth and beauty and to create that beautiful high cheek that also lifts the jawline by creating some volume up here. And then the last part, of course, we do our massage. Where we put the product on the periosteal level, which is the high cheek and the temple, it's not as important for the massage, but a lot of times I use a high concentration here because we get results quicker. The lower face, when we do the preauricular area, but particularly the jawline and the lower face where the orbicularis oris is, that muscle will want to move product and clump it together. So by massaging 5-5-5 times a day for 5 days for 5 minutes at a time, that will prevent the Sculptra product from moving to one area to create a nodule, because nodules aren't from granulomas typically, they're from clumping of product and the muscle wants to move the product together. So the patient does have homework with this procedure, but it's very easily completed a few times a day, and we always massage circular and up. And you can already see we have a nice, high, beautiful cheekbone. The skin here with the combination of the PRF and PLLA in a totally different concentration of the lower face to the upper face just creates beautiful skin. So that's the Plasmasculpt procedure. What we did in total was we put Plasmasculpt periosteally here. We didn't do the temple today. Sometimes we will, but she has a good temple. We did the under eye where we wanted to tighten skin. We actually filled the nasolabial fold with PRF and the Plasmasculpt solution. And then we did that lower face because we noticed she was getting loose skin and aging here a little more than the upper face, which was more youthful.